And as head of this chamber, I will tell you, I will study your resignation and make a decision in due time. I will consult the members of the chamber about it. We are not going to do this rashly. For today, we are witnessing the happening of a historical event, for this is the first time within the reach of my memory, of my 87 years in this planet. This is the first time that a man, a member of this chamber, chose honor ahead of himself. Bayan muna bago sarili. That is the meaning of what you did. And so, I commend you as head of this chamber. We do not say goodbye because I'm sure you will be back. But nonetheless, we bid you well. And we hope to see you again. And you are always a member of this chamber, even if you are out of it in the meantime. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. We wish to, I'm sure most of us, if not all of us, would want to associate ourselves to the statements made by the Senate President.
Thank you.
And with that, Mr. President, may we ask the members of the Senate, our colleagues, to join the Senate President and the Chairman of the Committee on Finance on a very important caucus that will be held in the Senator's Lounge as soon as I ask for a suspension of the session, Mr. President.
Thank you.
So I move to suspend the session.
Session suspended.
You have Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri being greeted by hugs from the people at the Senate, his family. He was just the subject of a speech by the Senate President lauding him for his actions. As widely expected, Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri has announced he is resigning from the Senate, saying that accusations of cheating in the 2007 elections and the resulting doubts that it cast on his mandate have hurt his family, the Senate as an institution, and the electoral system, or rather the belief in the electoral system, while he decried the trial by publicity that he was being subjected to as a result of recent revelations concerning poll fraud. Senator Zubiri vigorously denied being involved in any cheating. Zubiri said he wanted to end the divisiveness that the cheating accusations had caused and to lift the burden that had been placed on his loved ones. Zubiri wrapped up his speech citing his prolific legislative record. He then bid farewell and gave thanks to his Senate colleagues one by one, as well as to those who voted for him. Zubiri ended the approximately half-hour-long valedictory speech by promising that he would continue serving, but in a different capacity. Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri has resigned. Zubiri gave up his Senate seat over allegations he benefited from cheating in the 2007 elections. Zubiri maintained he did not cheat and was himself a victim of fraud, but he added he resigned to spare the Senate and his family from further controversies brought about by the fraud allegations.
I am resigning not because I am exhausted from the demands of my calling as a legislator. Hindi po ako napagod sa paglilingkod sa inyo. I'm resigning not because I wish to evade the decision of the Senate Electoral Tribunal. Handa ko pong tanggapin ang anumang hatol mula sa nasabing hukuman. Rather, I'm resigning because of these unfounded accusations hurled against me and that these issues has systematically divided our nation and has casted doubts in our electoral system, which has affected not only myself, but this institution together with the public as well. And as a legislator who is being referred to in the Senate as your honor, I believe that my honor is something that should never be subject to taint. No amount of power.
Let's now get a reaction from Koko Pimentel. Good afternoon, Attorney Pimentel.
Hi, good afternoon.
Yes, I'm sorry, but I'm not hearing you very well. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I could hear you.
All right. Well, I was watching you as Senator Zubiri was delivering his speech, and I didn't detect any particular reaction. How are you feeling?
I'm quite disappointed that he labeled the poll fraud charges as baseless.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the evidence is everywhere. In my protest, we have opened the ballot boxes. The ballots were all fake, coming from Maguindanao. And now we have Zaldi Ampatuan giving us a recorded statement on how it was done and who ordered it. We have Lintang Bidol, who also executed an affidavit. And then we have three municipal election supervisors also executing affidavits. So these are not baseless or unfounded election fraud charges. These are real. And the sooner that he accepts this fact, the better also for him, for his peace of mind also.
Mm-hmm. Well, he has resigned, sir. Is it important still whether he admits to the cheating allegations?
That it's important. It's also significant that he has resigned. It's a rare act. But I was hoping that he was doing it based on the right reasons. That these poll fraud accusations or charges are not baseless.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you make of Mr. Zubiri's directive that the Senate Electoral Tribunal continue its hearing of your protest as well as his protest and to resolve this as soon as possible?
Now that he has resigned, that means that he's no longer contesting the position,
mm-hmm.
or he's no longer interested in the position. Therefore, I believe as a lawyer that that makes his counter protest moot and academic. And I will ask my lawyer is Senator Nene Pimentel, on what next steps we should do, what motions we should file to also expedite the proceedings.
Mm-hmm. So you believe that it's important that the Senate Electoral Tribunal still rule on your protest?
Only the SET can proclaim a new senator, because there is no election, so the COMELEC cannot do it, and then only the SET, and only because that position that Mig Zubiri is vacating is a contested position.
Mm-hmm. So it's not as if this is not something that can be, that he can simply be replaced by you, for instance, as the supposedly the person right beneath him in the elections, right?
Yes, Twink. The SET should put a closure to the protest, and the SET should proclaim who the real winner is.
Okay, so, and the SET, as according to you, cannot actually proclaim or replace Mr. Zubiri until it has ruled on your protest.
Yes, but it can do so, I think, in less than a month's time, because all the data are in, and, you know, the account is already in, and they know already the results.
Okay, final question to you, Attorney Pimentel. We did have Senator Ponce Enrile saying that he still had to decide whether to accept the resignation of Juan Miguel Zubiri. Do you see that as something that's possibly a problem?
You know, a nationally elected leader resigns directly to the people, not to his colleagues, not to the leader of the chamber, because his mandate comes from the people, and I think that the resignation of Miguel Zubiri is effective immediately.
All right. Thank you very much for talking to us, Attorney Koko Pimentel. Today's breaking news, of course, that Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri has resigned.